Here's top 5 John Wayne movies that aren't westerns. You probably know American actor John Wayne for his roles in westerns. So you might be a little surprised to discover the following diverse films from the Duke's long career. According to biographer Ronald Davis, John Wayne personified for the millions.
In front of the millions! Don't think you heard me, The Rock will do it in front of the millions!
The nation's frontier heritage. 83 of his movies were westerns, and in them, he played cowboys, cavalrymen, and unconquerable loners extracted from the Republic's central creation myth. In total, Wayne starred in 142 films, nearly half were not westerns. Not only do directors typecast, placing an actor in similar roles, but we as viewers do too. So let's take a look at some other less-cowboy John Wayne movies. First up, we have North to Alaska. During the Alaskan Gold Rush, a prospector sends his friend Sam, played by John Wayne, to pick up his would-be bride from far away. When it turns out she's already married another man, Sam returns with a substitute. From its opening theme to its playful lumberjack games, this film is lighthearted and joyful. Interestingly, Alaska had just achieved its statehood in 1959 and was very much in news. While North Alaska has been described as a northern western, the setting holds a flavor distinctly its own. In the number 2 spot, we have The Green Berets. The Green Berets is set during the Vietnam War, a topic fresh on the minds of viewers at the time of its release. It was one of only a few films about the war to be produced during the same war. The plot revolves around Colonel Mike Kirby, played by John Wayne, commanding a group of soldiers charged with a special mission of capturing a high-ranking Viet Cong officer. In the United States, history textbooks spend few pages describing the Vietnam War. In my experience as a student, classes seldom reach such near history regardless. The Vietnam War was also highly controversial. That fact often leaves former soldiers and opposers alike at a loss for words when asked about the event. The Green Berets, while published as a fictional novel in 1965, does not overlook the unpleasant details of this period in history. The writer trained with U.S. Special Forces and accompanied them on a 1963 deployment. This film, therefore, may be one of the closest things to a history lesson many will experience concerning this rocky period. Number 3, Donovan's Reef. Guns Donovan, a World War II veteran played by John Wayne, lives on a peaceful South Pacific island with an amusing cast of characters. Tensions rise when Doc Dedham's daughter arrives, looking for signs that he's broken the conditions of a will that would be in her benefit. Though a lighthearted comedy, this tropical adventure subtly touches on issues such as racial bigotry, social superiority, and corporate greed. For example, the character Amelia, a wealthy Boston heiress, first refers to children that she believes belongs to Donovan as half-caste. Later, she learns that they are her half-siblings and has a change of heart. She also changes her views as to the backwardness she had assumed to find there. Are those wedding bells she's hearing? Number 4, Hellfighters. Chance Buckman, played by John Wayne, fights oil fires for a living. It's a dangerous job, and his wife couldn't stand the strain of not knowing whether or not her husband would come home to her. When Chance's daughter falls for a fellow firefighter, can their budding relationship withstand the tension? Based loosely on the life story of oil firefighter Red Adair, who served as a technical advisor for the film, this adventure is like nothing you've ever seen. It combines exotic disasters, warfare, heroism, and conversant family drama to form a completely original plot. Despite the draw of John Wayne's stardom, this was the first film for which he was paid $1 million. Yet it still represents a varied facet of the Duke's career.
Duke Kaboom, Canada's greatest stuntman. Oh yeah.
Not you, Duke. In the number 5 spot, we have The Quiet Man. Retired American boxer Sean Thornton returns to his hometown in Ireland. There, he is met with both friendship and outright hostility as he seeks to purchase his family's estate and settle down with a local girl. Comedic and sweetly romantic, this film represents a quieter side of John Wayne's career. Wayne's typical backdrop of dry and sandy western landscapes are absent. They give way to the award-winning cinematography of the lush and verdant Irish countryside. Wayne's character carries no gun and fights no fateful battles.
Come on, Kenny. Come on, Kenny.
Come on.
Come on, Kenny.
Do it.
I'll shoot you, say you fell in the kitchen.
The Quiet Man is perhaps the most divergent of John Wayne's films. It has earned its place in pop culture as well. A scene from the film is featured in E.T. the Extraterrestrial. the alien is intrigued by a kissing scene, which his human counterpart simultaneously reenacts at school. Well, guys, we hope you got to learn a little bit more about the Duke.
Duke, we need
Hold on. One more. Oh, yeah.
Still not you, Duke. I gotta go for now, but until next time, love the geek. Peace.